Breeze Cafe. How are you doing, Miss Lee?
I'm doing great.
You know what? I know that you are such an amazing educator. Sometimes you get the opportunity to travel, don't you?
Once in a while.
Every now and then.
When they let me out of the office.
Every now and then you get a chance to travel.
Yes,
and let's say, for example, you're traveling and you don't have a GPS system.
Mm-hmm. I do get lost.
Often. Yes. Well, tell me, what would you do if you needed to find, say, the location or the telephone number of a business?
I sometimes call home or call somebody and say, would you Google this for me and call me back?
Yep.
I've done that.
That's one way to do it.
Yeah.
I know that a lot of times I hate to do it because it costs money, but I would just call information.
I've done that also. But that's like $1.25
right,
or something.
Exactly.
Yeah, so I really try not to
call
do that.
Call 411,
yes.
Get the number, but you have to make sure that you know the exact name of the business, right?
Right.
And then you get the telephone number to the business.
Right.
And then once you get that information, you hang up, then you call the business.
Right. And sometimes they'll text it to you, but then you have to read the text. And you're driving, and that's not real safe. So.
Right. So there's all kinds of things that are going on with that. But our website of the week, which is based off of Google, it's /Goog411. It is a solution to all of that dealing with the business world.
Solutions are good.
And they
like
are
those.
What? Free. Thank you. So let's take a look at our website of the week.
I think I saw a glass break.
Why? So we look right here. It's very easy. What this website will allow you to do is basically you can call 1-800-GOOG-411 from any phone. It can be your cell phone or it can be a landline phone. You can state the location and the business type So let's say you don't know.
Okay.
Say you just know we're in Boca and you want to go to Maggiano's.
All right.
Just state it on the phone and they'll connect you to that business for free, and then you're done.
Really?
Yes, it's very, and you don't pay for this at all. But it doesn't work for residential things yet. They don't have that upline, but they have for any type of business.
So if I'm somewhere else, and I don't know the area, and I need a taxi, I can just call and say where I am, and then I need a taxi, and they'll find one for me.
That's exactly right.
Awesome.
That's exactly right. Now, I wanted to play just a little clip of this video because this is an introduction to the service. He gives lots of information about it. I'm just going to play the beginning of it, but our viewers can see it a little bit later if they want to see the whole thing. As you can see, it just comes up.
Hi, my name is Brian. I'm a voice researcher here at Google. I'm here to tell you about Goog 411, Google's new 411 service. It's totally free, and it's really easy to use. Call 1-800-GOOG-411. That's
And as you can see, he goes through all of the steps that are already on this page for you. So it's very cool. I want to get to
He's a voice researcher.
That's what he calls himself. He calls himself a voice researcher. And it has some things about what people say about Goog 411 and how it works and the fact that it is voice activated. So these are just some people who have used it, and they really can see the how much is going to be helping in the future. But I wanted to go over here to FAQ. They have some answers to a lot of the questions that you might have about the service. It gives you an overview where it works. It works anywhere in the United States and Canada, but not outside. So it would need to be right here. The supported language is only English, so they haven't uploaded like French or Spanish or anything of that nature. Again, you can use a cell phone or you can use a landline phone, which is perfectly fine. And they don't have information about the residential information right now. So right now it's just businesses. And right now they don't support any advertising or anything of that nature. So you can click on this and it'll give you the more detailed information about that. Now, here's the cool thing about finding a specific business. Let's say, for example, you don't know the exact name of the restaurant. Like I said, Maggiano's.
Mm-hmm.
Now, let's say I just know that it's an Italian restaurant.
Mm-hmm.
When you call Goog 411, you don't have to say Maggiano's. You can say Italian restaurant. And it will pull up the Italian restaurants in the area that you're looking for.
Really?
And then you can go through that information and pick out, you can find Maggiano's that way. So it's a much broader search that allows you to be able to go through that. Now, here's another really cool thing. If you are using a cell phone, you can have them, you can say text. You can say the word text.
Uh-huh.
And they will send you information as well in a text message on your cell phone so that you can have that. Let's say, for example, like you said, it's not safe to drive, read while you're driving. But let's say you wanted to go to this restaurant later on this evening. So they'll text the information to you, and then you can read the information later on in the evening.
Sure.
Another very, very cool thing about this is that it will allow you to map it. So let's say, for example, you don't have your GPS system, and you are looking for the information, but you don't know where you are.
So right. So you found your Italian restaurant, but now you need to know how to get there.
Right. And same way, you would just call on the phone, you would say the word map it, and it would send you directions, Google map directions,
wow,
to your cell phone of this location. So you can get the telephone number, you can get the address, you can get the sent as a text message to you, and you can get the directions just like that.
Wow.
To any business, anywhere you're going. Now, the interesting thing is, let's say you are a business. Now, it's going to pull the information that's in the database for your business. Let's say you find out, though, that information is not correct.
Mm-hmm.
You as a business owner can go and you can actually update your business information. It says that Goog411 uses listing information provided by Google Maps. Now, let's say that information is incorrect. You can go to this little link right here where it says editing instructions for Google Maps. And once you go here, it takes you through all of the instructions that
to make it more accurate.
To make it
so
more
this is
accurate.
Community-driven.
It really is community-driven.
That's great.
So you can change it. It gives the most up-to-date information as long as the businesses are, you know, interacting, mm-hmm, and the customers say, hey, I looked for you, but I ended up, you know, on the other side of town. I didn't realize that you moved. Well, the business can go right here and follow these very simple steps to be able to update their and correct their information. And again, it's very simple. They would just sign into their account. If they didn't have an account, they would just need to go ahead and create an account, and then they would click on more info, they would edit, and then it would claim your business. Once your business, mm-hmm, is claimed, then you have the authority to be able to come in and change the information.
Yeah.
You change the information, you upload it, and it's done.
I know we don't have time to get into that, but I wonder how businesses claim their business so that, for example, a competing business doesn't grab another one and sabotage.
We should call Google and ask them.
Goog411. Hey, Google, how does that work?
We need to hear the voice. What did he call himself?
The voice researcher.
The voice researcher.
Yeah. Research this.
So this is a really cool thing. Another thing that is pretty good is it prevents. They have privacy things that are going on. It gives you information. You can block your caller ID so that, you know, it's not, because, you know, you're calling from your cell phone.
Sure.
It allows you to be able to block your caller ID. And they have, like, their privacy policy that's here. It has very limited information collection. It says there are a couple of ways you can control the way that they collect and store information from your calls. First, delete any information that there's associated with your phone number. You can ask them to do that, and you can go right here to follow the steps from there. So if you are proactive and you're saying, hey, I don't want any information from my calls, mm-hmm, to be collected by anybody else,
sure,
it gives you an opportunity,
yeah,
to be able to protect
yourself. Because a lot of people are
that.
Reluctant to give their information out, and so they can feel comfortable still using this service, knowing that, you know, depending on what level of privacy they're looking for,
that's
they
right.
can still secure that.
Because some, you know, some people don't care, but then some people care very much, and
right.
so it gives that option from this site. So I just think it's a wonderful tool that's
yeah.
free, that's technology-based from, you know, big name like Google, and they're providing other things out there for
yeah,
us to be able
absolutely.
To be able to learn. So thank you, Google, and we'll be back with more Palm Breeze.